In our previous video in this series, we showed how to use the Polycam app to scan a regular sized object. In this video, we will show you what to do to scan large objects. This video is part of a series on how to scan objects and 3D print them. If you are new to this channel and don't want to miss out on the next video, then subscribe to this channel. If you haven't seen part 1, then we strongly recommend watching it, as we won't repeat every step. For this tutorial, you will need most of the tools from part 1, but in addition, you need a drone. So, as an example object, we take the Valle Maggia monolith. This is a 14-meter high granite block, which is cut diagonally in two. Both parts are held with rods, and there is an RGB light in the middle which changes color at night. To avoid strong shadows, we did the scan after the sun set behind the mountains. The method is to fly circles around the block and then increase the height, and repeat it until we reach the top. Then we take additional pictures from farther away. To cover details around the ground and towards the top, we use a handheld camera. When we are finished, we download all pictures to a computer. Then we go to the Polycam website and create a new scan and upload all photos. We choose the highest setting. After 15 to 20 minutes, we have the result. Unfortunately, the gap was not properly scanned. These kinds of issues of small gaps in big objects happen all the time, but we can easily fix it. We can just cut the hole ourselves and remodel the rods. If you have never used Blender or any 3D modeling software, you should check tutorials before continuing. Going here in details would blow the scope of this video. So, first we start like last time. Download the GLTF file and import it in Blender. Merge the mesh by selecting the non-manifold vertices and then merging by distance. Then we use the box and lasso trims in sculpting mode to extract the object. We scale the object to get the correct real height of 14 meters. On the lower part we add some rods. For that we create some cylinders and place them at the right place. Then we recreate the gap using the lasso and trim tool. For easier printing and painting, we split the model in an upper and lower part. So that both parts can be aligned, we need to add mounting holes in the upper part. We create the holes with a boolean from larger cylinders. For the LED, we create a hole in the lower part as well as a tube for the wiring. Then we import it in a slicer software and add some supports. Then we 3D print it. We print both parts in the same print to save time. So now we paint it and here is the final construction on the layout. As a bonus, you can download the model, the link is in the description. You might want to scale it to the size you need. So, what about buildings like houses? You proceed exactly the same. We scan Sven Magnus house. The result is quite good, but it's not the quality what you accept from a kit. So I tried to remodel it, which takes a lot of time. And that amount of 3D modeling is outside the scope of this video. We also scanned a much larger building, in this case Fleischer's Hotel in Voss. So we flew the drone around it. Then we took additional pictures with our pocket cam. The result is quite good, but again it's not usable to create a quality kit. Also, just killing the building to scale would result in a monster building which is nearly 1 meter long. The sprinting of such a large part is not possible, so it requires some clever splitting. But that's also outside the scope of that video. Is it possible to scan a building without a drone? We did a test of the structures of Burgund where drone flying is forbidden. We just walked around it, but from the result you can see big holes in the model, so it's completely useless. So we conclude that scanning large objects works best for irregular or organically shaped objects. Building with regular form and repeating detail won't work that well, but the 3D scan can be used for further processing. In the next video, we will show you how to scan people. We hope to see you soon again in the training room.